right? Am I doing this right? Yo, calm down. There we go. Is this right? Am I doing it? Am I recording? All right, here we go, dude. Let's talk about team compositions while I wait for the delay. On the blue side, we have GP in the top lane. Knowing Maniac's Mayhem, that's probably going to be an AP GP, but I guess we're going to have to get into the game to really find out here. We got Lee VM in the jungle with Nunu. He's probably going to be a terror with that Blood Boil and Jinx on ADC. That is going to be the terror squad of turret pushing. I know me back when I played, and Brim back when we were on the same team in the LCS, we used to run this strat quite a bit. Generally, CD Hizzy was a mid laner back then, and he liked to play Nidalee at that time, and the attack speed would be around about 2.5 at level 9. It was pretty intense, and the turrets fell faster than than I did down the stairs yesterday. So, Zamray breaks silence to say lol for no fucking reason. You fucked me up, Zamray. Damn it, what's going on? I was on a roll. Alright, and Iron Man in the mid lane with the Victor pick. This will be Victor's debut into the LCS, along with GP, actually. Alright, now let's talk about purple side since we used up half our time talking about blue. Over here on the purple side, we've got Zyra, which I think is going to be a support lane. And name escapes me. Varus as ADC. Now, this is the interesting thing, is that neither ADC is very mobile. So we're going to see how that plays into the team. We have TF in the mid lane, which is a lot more mobile than Victor. However, if played correctly, I think Victor can win this lane pretty easily. I don't really know. I'm not a mid laner. We got Shaco in the jungle. This is probably the matchup we're going to have to watch. It's Nunu Shaco. Those are pretty early gankers and fairly equal in counter jungle prowess. So we're gonna have to see. That's our featured matchup for this game. Is gonna be in the jungle.
Oh my god!
No, don't make me.
Shut up, Lee. Lee, you're the featured matchup. There's nothing you can do about it.
Let's be it, dude.
All right, featured matchup from Lee in the jungle, and HDD Jeff in the purple jungle. All right, and it looks like we're gonna get this underway. Alright, I'm gonna leave this Skype call though, because I'm gonna be like minutes behind talking about shit that fucking
behind the scenes.
Yeah, dude. Alright. Well, I'm gonna come back, I'm gonna send you guys the video so you guys can watch this amazing commentation while I play RuneScape on the side. Alright. Now I get down to business. Turn that down. Alright. As the teams load into the Rift, we're going to notice quite a few things. First of all, blue team outskins purple team. This is an important factor for several reasons. One being, obviously, blue team just cares more about the way they look. And that's also just as important as the gameplay itself. So, here we can see Zamray on his toaster. And Bruce Lean on his potato, going about equal speeds of register here. That's what I like to see. Oh my god, hurry up. Jesus fuck. Not really much to say at this point, at this juncture. I guess we talk about our featured matchup. Shaco, who was unranked last season, as I see here. And Lee, who was in silver last season. I don't actually know the deets. Let me look this up here. Alright, let's do this. I think Fiora is going to win the matchup in the top lane, but I guess we'll have to wait and see. Alright, looks like we have a Plat 5 mid laner versus a Bronze 3 mid laner. This could spell trouble for the blue team. If TF really gets going, there's not going to be a whole lot they can do against it. He's going to assassinate somebody. He's going to zone you. It's going to be a problem. They're not going to have a good time. Then in the top lane, we've got a Gold 5 GP against a Gold 2 Fiora. This should be roundabout evenly matched in mechanics. Decision-making, I think, is going to be a little different. I think Fiora should be a little bit smarter in decision-making based on rank alone. Zamore, Silver 5 versus Blue Penguin, Silver 1. That's also a pretty close matchup. Generally speaking, they're pretty close in the amount of ranked games they win versus lose. Just Zamore's played less, which does grant less experience. It looks like Chris has opted for the flash over the wall lamp. No, they walked into it. Are they going to get first blood? No, but they do get the heal. That's important. Because now he does not have heal in the lane. Chris is usually a pretty aggressive support. I've played with him a few times. He enjoys playing aggressive. And I think I've PC'd. Come on. Why can't I see what's going on? Hopefully I can still... Here we go. Alright. Looks like we're gonna load back into the Rift. The game has been paused from my end because I can't see anything, which is fine. I don't need to see. Just come to. All right. Here we get to see it again. They walk into the brush, and they really give this Varus what for. I'm not sure about the flay pick. It did offer a lot of auto attack damage, but a hook might have actually gotten here we see Twisted Fate pulling out the try hard card from the deck. But as I always say, if you're not gonna try, why play? Okay, looks like we're gonna have a standard red start from blue side and a standard blue start for Shaco. Looks like Zyra's gonna give a leash, even though Shaco has his boxes. It's not a bad idea, considering that Varus couldn't even get to lane to begin with, so she didn't want to push that lane. Definitely a decent use of her time. Then from the Mana Crystal start up in the top lane, it looks like... It is going to be the legendary APG GP. And now we watch as things unfold. Looks like Zamore and Chris are really giving it to this bottom lane. I'm anxious to see how this unfolds. Looks like they ping two. They get the hook onto Blue Penguins. Get the flay. There goes the... Rocket, and there it is. First blood goes to Zamore. I really hope Chris is talking to him and helping him do what is necessary. I'm glad he switched to Rockets there. He probably would not have gotten that kill had he not. It was a good heads-up play. Let's look at our CS here. Looks like he's also up 7 CS, which is only going to continue to grow as he stays in lane and Varus has to walk all the way back. In the mid lane, we've got... Oh, there's another amazing hook from Chris. The rocket and the auto attack. And that's a fucking Another kill down in the bottom lane for blue team. Lee comes in with the gank. The parry comes out. That's about all they can do with that. And Maniacs does tank a turret shot there. But it's still an even trade. And Chris is thirsty for blood. I hope he builds a bloodthirster this game, because that would only make sense. Lee comes back around, gets the slow on Shaco, possibly saving Maniac's life. That was a good return gank by Lee. Here we see Chris with his thirsty ass. What the fuck? Can I please? Can I please watch the game? Okay. And here we go again. Okay, there we go. And looks like he is going to get another kill. Zamray probably should have tried to sidestep out of the creeps there. He would have taken a little less damage, but you know, all in all, he got the kill and he got out alive, so it was good. Looks like this bottom lane is going to snowball pretty hard. They're probably going to have to worry about this bottom lane. Shaco needs to get down there and needs to start making something happen. Otherwise, this bottom lane may snowball completely out of control. Alright, let's take a look at the mid lane again. We've got 13 CS for blue. Victor, Iron is CSing. He's not doing too bad. Probably needs to hit a couple more CS. Twisted Fate is at 25, so that CS lead is probably going to continue to grow for TF, and that's not necessarily a good thing for Iron. And when I say necessarily, I mean at all. It's definitely a bad thing, because TF passive is just going to continue to give him more and more gold. Victor really needs to catch up and farm, and possibly even get a gank here or there to give him a couple of kills, because he's going to need some gold. Maniac's Mayhem up in the top lane with that APGP is not farming very well. However, he did just TP back to lane, and Fiora does not have that option. She's going to have to walk. Going to miss some CS. And hopefully he is stacking quite a bit of gold. Let's go check on that. He does have 40 extra gold, 45 extra gold. So he is slowly accumulating that gold back. He's got a couple CS in his name solely because of that. Here we see bottom lane pushing the turret pretty hard. Instead of Zamray opts to go for a trade there instead of getting the CS. I don't necessarily agree with that, especially because it missed. He should have just gone for the CS. Not a big deal, nothing lost there. Shaco, Chris sees it, and he pulls the lantern, gets the flay. Zyra gets a good root there. Is he gonna go down? There's the arrow, there's the kill. The ignite does get it. Here comes Lee in for the counter gank. It's a little late. Chris goes in a little deep. Is he gonna go down here as well? Here comes the piercing arrow, and he is. He is gonna go down. Looks like the bottom lane did get a little greedy right there. A little confident in the power that they didn't quite have yet. Alright, so TF is 6 now, so we're going to be expecting him to be ganking somewhere. My guess is going to be bot lane, because they did get that early lead on blue side. So looks like Lee's going to try and soak up this XP and this gold as best as humanly possible. Taking damage isn't too big of a deal. He's probably going to back here. He's out of mana. No, he looks like he's going to go clear his golems. Yeah, he is going to go clear his golems. He's going to consume. He'll back up. Continue farming. Okay, Maniac Mayhem is now down 23 CS. The biggest CS deficit for the team right now. He can't really get up to the creeps. It's one of the problems with playing GP. You know, I'd rather him, you know, be down in CS though like he is, than get up there and just die to Fiora. As you can see, he is taking a lot of damage. Okay, and backs off and gets out of life. Oh, great death sentence from Thresh. Saves him from the Chompers, but it didn't matter. Jinx does have that BF sword that Varus does not. There goes Varus buying his BF sword. I actually don't know Varus's name. I should probably... Blue Penguins buying that... BF sword. Another great hook from Thresh. MVP right here. He tanking turret shots. but it doesn't matter. They actually come out on top of that trade, I believe. Especially because Jinx is going to ping 6 here and have that rocket. And if Zyra stays in lane and is too low, that rocket's going to be a big problem. And as you can see here, Chris talking about how he's going to lose the game because GP started Mana Crystal. I don't necessarily agree with that start either, but you know, it happened, and you're going to have to deal with it. Fuck it. Alright, here we see Shaco coming down to the bottom lane. Like I said, he's going to have to gank that lane so that Varus can come back into the game. He's only down 7 CS at this point, which is not a whole lot. Victor did DC. His internet's been pretty shoddy. I wonder if I can... I cannot. I was hoping I could talk to them. Bruce Lee is showing some real concern for the team. Victor is DCing here and there, probably lagging, which is probably not helping with this CS game. It looks like he chose to go Augment Death, which is going to increase his damage on his laser. So if he starts landing that laser, it's really going to do a lot of damage. Here goes Chris with another great Flay Lantern into a gank. Zamray needs to reposition here. He's taking too much free damage. Almost another great hook from Thresh. Looks like he's going to get Bloodboiled into another Flay. There's the Cork, and there's the red buff finish. Alright, we see TF was roaming down there for what I assume to be a gank, but his ultimate is down, so I don't really know what he was doing. Back up to the top lane, where the CS lead is still at 23. Iron Man DCs yet again, and reconnects though. That's good. Alright, GP wasted flash there. That's a big win for Fiora. Now she's 2-0. Almost another great hook from Thresh. And it was very smart of them to back off there. As soon as Shaco went over the wall, it was very good of them to back up. Down in the bottom lane, it's 3-2-3 on Zamray's Jinx versus Varus's 1-4-1. So down in the bottom lane, they should want to try and press a lead here, but the CS lead isn't really in their favor. It is in their favor, but only by a couple. It's about to go to nil. There it is. Supports are just about even in score. Obviously, Adelina, or Adeline, or Ari, as I was told to call her, is... Fuck, what was I gonna say? Opting for Spell Thief over Targan, so has a little bit less CS. But probably overall more accumulated gold, I'm going to say, because she has 10 pure CS along with the Spell Thief. Here we see Zamray trying to fend off his turret. He needs to switch to, there he goes, back to the Gatling gun. Trying to last it. He gets ulted, but he gets the chomper off. Is this going to be enough? Here comes Thresh. Gonna finish off that kill? No, he is not. He does try his best. He flashes a little late. He's tanking that turret. He's not gonna go down. Looks like they juggled that just perfectly enough. Here comes Lee in for the gank. Does he have ultimate? No, he doesn't, but he's got the ice cube and he's got the fist pound. Just absolutely decimates Blue Penguin. That is what I'm talking about, Lee. Iron Man DCs again. Looks like Bruce Lean is gonna BM him, knowing he has DC problems, and apologized to secretly kill him while he DCs. And no one expects anything. Great rocket from Zamray picking up that kill in the mid lane. Cannot believe that was a very heads up play. Very heads up play. Iron Man's connection really, really slack in here. GP does have a kill, which is important. He's got 5 mana pots, so he's really looking to start spamming that Q, farm, and harass, hopefully. Bruce Lean. Asking if he should fight Iron Man even though he's having bad connection problems. Chris coming in with the no mercy call, no captives. looks like they're out for blood just as expected. Thresh is going to build a Bloodthirster, I think, because he's thirsting. One thirsty ass nigga. Okay, and looks like Iron Man agreeing. No mercy to be had down here today. This is going to be a cutthroat game. Alright, Iron Man is now down by 28 CS. The CS deficit that he had. Lee going in for the counter jungle while Fiora comes up for the kill on top lane. Gonna ult. Might not actually get it because of that heal. Does not get it. Has to back up. Varus is about to go down. The flash comes out from Lee. The flash comes out from Zyra. And Jinx is gonna go down. Here comes the TF ulti down, probably on Lee. He puts down the Vortex. Gonna get the stun. No, he's not. Flash comes out from TF. 100% not necessary. That's a win for the blue team. Maniac's Mayhem getting caught again. And another Ignite comes down. Could have sworn I just saw her use Ignite. Whatever. Okay, here we see the Battle of Supports. The level 9 Zyra, who's been getting solo farm XP for quite some time, against the level 7 Thresh. Looks like neither of them really want it. Another almost great rocket from Zamray. Just missing by a hair. Would have been a great pickup if he got that there. One thing I'd really like to see out of GP is some sort of Zhonya's second item. I realize Lich Bane is, you know, the bread and butter of AP GP. However, I really believe that if he doesn't get Zhonya soon, Fiora's gonna start snowballing out with control. So I really hope he picks that up. Okay, here we see Thresh going in, getting that kill on the counter jungling Shaco. We're gonna ignore that hook as if it never happened. Chris is a god. Alright, here we have the Blood Boil Jinx. This is the power I was talking about. Let's see if they can siege this up. Looks like Fiora's coming down. They really need to be careful here. GP does not have ult currently. If they get caught in a fight by a Varus ulti, they're probably going to get mauled apart because of this Fiora ulti. Thresh almost landing another hook there. Looks like they're just really feeling each other out here. Shaco's here. It is now a 5-on-4 for purple team if they choose to go in. Fiora decides to back for whatever reason. Not really sure why she would do that. I think she should have definitely pushed with her team, 5v4 fought, and tried to take down mid lane. But she opts not to do that, and the creeps take the turret on the bottom lane. So throughout this neutral scrap, looks like purple team is going to come out on top there. Okay, another missed hook from Chris. I assume he must be lagging because Chris does not miss hooks. He's a god. Alright, here we can see blue team realizing that purple team is on the dragon, so they're going to go in for that. While Iron Man gets pushed into the mid lane, looks like they're going to go smite steal. What a great play. What a great play from blue team, really using communication there. He throws the lantern in instead of hooking in and throwing the lantern out for Nunu so he can flash out. He flashes in, smite consumes, steals the dragon, lanterns back out. What a fantastic play from blue team. They really needed that. Evens up the gold. 100 gold difference right now. No, it's completely even. Fiora coming down the mid and not doing anything has really helped GP. He's been starting to catch up back up in farm. Here he ults to try and save the turret, which he does end up doing, actually. Almost at the cost of his life, but looks like he has accumulated 368 gold from his Q, which is gonna even up that CS deficit pretty heftily. The fuck. Alright, looks like Shaco going in on Iron Man. Great flash, great gravity field, good hook. Is he gonna go in? Use the ulti! Good job there. If he can get out of this, he does. Looks like Zyra is gonna go down. Great play by blue team there. Lee VM is going hard in the paint. 5-0-2 on Nunu with 75 CS over Shaco's 44. Right now he is winning the featured matchup. Looks like, I believe, who just flashed? What the fuck? Alright, Zot Fiora coming in from nowhere. There's the exhaust. TF porting in. Zamorin needs to get out of there. Here comes the Thresh hook. Oh, good hook, good hook. Alright, here you see him kiting. He needed to get out of there. The flash ulti from Varus does finish the kill there. And Lee is going to get out okay with his Blood Boil. This brings it still completely even game. Absolutely surprising. I think the D1 player being on support definitely helping the rank out in this team. What a fantastic hook from Chris. I don't know if you guys saw that, but he was going for the invisible Shaco, and it was almost right there. It was great, great, great hook. He definitely was not trying to hook the minion and miss completely, because Chris is gone. Alright, here we see purple team sieging down mid lane, and we can no longer spectate. It's a fucking lie. I don't care what anyone says. I can spectate. If I want to spectate. You can't stop me. Looks like the game is down for just a moment while we fix this issue. I'm going to eat some craisins. Alright, looks like we're loading back up onto the Rift. Shoot, we missed here. Looks like not much. Thresh went down the mid lane. That looks like they're all 5 mid, and they're gonna siege mid, I believe. They have a great tower taking team. They have an ADC. Obviously, always good at taking down turrets. A TF who went Zhonya's first. Not sure if I agree with that. Heady went Lich Bane. They really take that turret down. Here we go. We're about to see the damage from APGP. Looks like the Sheen proc. I don't know what happened there. I barely did any damage. It looks like they're really trying to push purple team back. Purple team's trying to back. It looks like they're going to give this mid turret. No, they are not. Okay. Looks like... Oh, a great hook from Thresh. Looks like they're just going to use it to poke, though. Looks like purple team is going to back. Looks like they're going to give this mid turret away to blue team 100% for free. No! Chris, that's fuck yo back. Here's a hook to the face. Not sure why he did that. He should have just let her back. Looks like they're going to go for the dive here. No, looks like they're just going to take the turret. Shaco hops over the wall and then runs back around. If that was a TF ulti, I'd call it the Twisted Fadeaway, but it wasn't. I'll have to come up with something clever later. A flash from Zyra. Now, I don't entirely think the flash for the Quark was necessary. However, that hook, had she not flashed, would have killed her. The Varus ulti comes down. Iron Man does not grab the lantern, and he pays the price for his life. Looks like the GP ult comes down with the slow. There goes the rocket. In comes the Nunu ult. They get one for one there. Almost 2 for 2. GP's going for it. Does not get it. Blue Penguin's coming up big with the triple kill. Why is that like that again? There we go. Coming up with the triple kill, evening up the gold in the bottom lane. 455 Zamorin to 555 Varus. 107 CS to both of them. Looks like Thresh right now sitting at a 2.0 KDA. Zyra sitting a little bit over 2 points. Hitting those rockets. But he gets binded by Zyra, so he's not going to be able to put out that much damage. Purple team pulls ahead with a 3.2k gold lead and a 3 tower lead. This is important to note that they have a 3 tower lead. If for whatever reason blue team starts to even up the gold without taking those towers, it is going to be a lot easier for them to come back. Their late game is not anywhere near as good as purple team's. However, if they play it correctly, they may be able to pull this one out of their ass. Alright, let's quickly look at our matchups here. GP to Fiora. let's look at the gold, because really CS isn't a huge factor. It looks like he's down 1,700 gold. I attribute that to the fact that he does not have near as much CS, although his Q is helping him kind of keep up with the flow of the game. He still is missing a lot. Xamarin needs to be careful for that bind. Good dodge there. Needs to try and not stand in damage range when he autos those plants. But it takes a lot of damage from Leandre's there. And into the jungle, we have a 503 Nunu with 86 CS and a 224 Shaco with 58 CS. Shaco is down 1,300 gold. Kind of evening up the top jungle. Gold is pretty even. It's actually almost dead even. A little bit in favor of Fiora in the top lane. Looks like Twisted Fate is going to blow up Xamarin there. Iron Man is going to go down again. He is now 0-5 and down 2.3k gold. Lee ulting going to get a two-man huge absolute zero. And I'm going to freeze. No, I'm going to lag. Thank God. And they're going to get the right one. Thresh gets the kill on that one. However, purple team slays the dragon. So, Maniac's Mayhem gonna go down here. He flashes, does not have W, so he goes down. Lee also goes down. This is not turning out well for the blue team. Fiora is absolutely snowballing out of control. Alright, there we see Twisted Fate picking up himself a free pink, and Varus picking up another turret. Turret lead now is 2-6 in favor of purple team, and the gold lead has increased to 7,000. This is a very large gold lead. It's enough to give each member on the team a little over 1,000 gold apiece in their prospective lane matchup. However, GP is now down 3,000 gold. He really needs to start farming earlier in the game, I think. Or, I don't really know how to play AP or GP, so I don't really know how he's going to come back in this game. I assume a couple of lucky ults where a lot of damage comes down is going to be important. He opted to go Deathcap instead of Zhonya's. I completely disagree with that build. However, Iron Man in the mid lane is opting to go for that Zhonya's, which is very important. I think Chris might have actually told him to do that. If not, he's a goddamn genius for figuring it out himself. I'm very proud of him. Zyra has also going for Zhonya's, and Xamarin has his Zeal IE. He's a little bit behind Varus in the pickup of the Static Shift or PD, whatever it is he chooses to go for. However, he does have Lifesteal and Varus does not. He's also increased the CS lead. Last we checked, the CS was 107 to 107. He has now picked up twice the CS Varus has in that time. However, he has gotten a lot less kills in that time. I don't know why Spectator is so fucking broken right now. But I can't imagine this game is going to go on much longer with Fiora running complete train on the blue team. Let's go right here. No, it looks like they're still in the game at 33 minutes. So I guess we'll just wait for the spectator lag bullshit to end. And Xamarin says OMG in the Skype call. I don't know if he's lagging or I don't even know what's going on here. Or if they lost. No, it does not look like they lost quite yet. Still waiting for this lag to pass. I guess we're gonna talk about stats and builds here for a while. Again, GP probably should have went Zhonya's. Picking up Boots of Lucidity instead of Sorc Shoes, which is not a bad pickup. There's no MR on the enemy team. Nunu opting for Randwins to help his team cut through the attack speed of Fiora. I hope he picks up Thornmail next. Or a Frozen Heart.
Then, again, Iron Man finishing that Zonius, getting a Negatron cloak. This is important because there is a lot of AP damage on the enemy team. Shaco's ultimate is 100% AP, obviously Twisted Fate AP. Zyra does an ungodly amount of AP damage as a supporter. So that is going to be pretty big, and Tanky Victor is actually a very viable Victor. Looks like Samurai is going to try and either pick up a Static Shiv or a PD, and then hopefully turn this into a Bloodthirster. We'll see how that goes, because there is no tank. He does not need to rush a Last Whisper. Thresh is picking up a Locket to try and help his team survive the team fight. As long as, I think after Locket, he should definitely go Frozen Heart. It looks like he's trying to finish out maybe his Sight Stone. But they definitely have more wards on their side of the map than Purple Team does. If they're going to come back into this game, I think that is how they're going to do it, is from picks. But it looks like the game is over. Purple Team did win. Spoiler alert. Ending the game 161 Iron Man with 8k gold. Least gold in the game. I probably attribute that to his constant desync. And the fact that he was only involved in 2 kills, it's not good. He needs to try and survive more fights, maybe position a little bit better. I don't really know. I didn't really see him too many times. Lee went from 503 to 646, probably. Looks like Samurai DC. Probably due to the fact that the team was down and he was trying to carry the team fight as Nunu. You can't really carry the entire team fight as Nunu, especially as a tank, so you're just gonna go in there and die a lot. A GP ending 5-9-1 with 9.7k gold, so he did even up the gold as far as his team is concerned. However, the entire enemy team was in double digits of gold, thousands of gold, and no one on this team was, so as you can see, the gold deficit is pretty large. Let's go to graph and go to damage dealt. Shaco down here with the almost the least damage in the game. Iron Man, the least damage in the game. Once again, he was DCing a lot. Fell behind pretty far. Possibly lagging and getting caught at the same time. Then Shaco. Looks like Thresh right where he should be. Not very much damage, but he's not at the top. GP just doing a little bit over the damage of Nunu. He did not get snowballing. He did not really get going. So he didn't really. I guess that's it for this one. I guess we're gonna play some more. Maybe I won't commentate the next one, but hopefully y'all enjoyed the commentary.